So in the last video, we saw that we learned that this happy prince is telling about this poor woman, poor widow woman who is stitching a cloth for a queen. Okay, so let's begin, continue now. In a bed in the corner of the room, her little boy is lying ill. He has a fever and is asking his mother to give him oranges. Okay, so there he saw that in the corner of the room, her son is lying there. Her son is lying ill and he is asking his mother to give him oranges. His mother has nothing to give him but river water. So he is crying. Okay, so her mother was poor and she did not have any oranges or any other fruits to give him except a river water. So he is crying. Swallow, swallow, little swallow. Will you not bring her the ruby out of my sword hilt? My feet are fastened to this pedestal and I cannot move. And therefore he requests a bird. Okay, he says the bird that swallow, swallow, go and give that woman a ruby. Take the ruby from her, from the sword hilt and give it to that poor lady. Okay, and this happy prince statue cannot move because he is being fastened in the pedestal. And that is why he cannot move from there. So he asks the bird, the swallow, to go and help that poor lady. I am waited for in Egypt, said the swallow. My friends are flying up and down the Nile and talking to the large lotus flower. Soon they will go to sleep. And therefore he makes an excuse that he have to move to Egypt. He also says that his friends have already reached and they are flying up and down to the up and down the Nile, and therefore he have to leave for Egypt. And also they are talking to lotus flower that now they are going to means, you know, the flower is going to get sleep. The prince asks the swallow to stay him for one night and be his messenger. The boy is so thirsty and the mother so sad, he said. So he requests, okay, he prayed to this bird that to stay for a night so that he can be a messenger of this happy prince statue. He asked that bird to go and help that poor lady and that little boy and to give him a water. But the happy prince looked so sad that the little swallow was sorry. It is very cold here, he said. But he agreed to stay with him for one night and be his messenger. Okay, so anyhow, the bird god agreed to happy prince and he agreed to stay there for a night. Thank you, little swallow, said the prince. The swallow picked out the great ruby from the prince's sword and flew away with it in his beak over the roofs of the town. So, what did the bird do? The bird, he went up and he took out the ruby from the sword hilt and he took that ruby in his beak and he went and he flew. Okay, he flew to the tower. Okay. He passed by Cathedral Tower where the white marble angels were sculptured. He passed by the palace and heard the sound of dancing. A beautiful girl came out of the balcony with her lover. And then the bird flew over the Cathedral Tower and there he saw a sculpture, a marble angel which was sculptured there. Okay, and then he passed the when he was passing by the palace, he heard some sound. And there he saw a beautiful girl coming in a balcony with her lover. I hope my dress will be ready in time for the state ball, she said. I have ordered flowers to be embroidered on it, but the semesters are so lazy. And that lady, that beautiful girl, was talking to a friend, and she was having conversation with him, and she was saying that whether her dress is ready or not. And she also claims that those semesters are what? They are lazy. He passed over the river and saw the lanterns hanging on the mast of the ship. At last he came to the poor woman's house and looked in. The boy was tossing feverishly in the bed, and the mother had fallen asleep. She was so tired. Okay, so next time. Okay, then when he was flying and flying, he came near, he passed over the river, and then there he reached that poor lady's home. And there he saw that her son was being shivering due to fever, and he was lying on his bed. He hoped and laid the great ruby on the table beside the woman's thimble. Then he flew gently round the bed, fanning the boy's forehead with his wings. "How cool I feel," said the boy. "I must be getting better." And he sank into a delicious slumber. Okay, so there the bird hoped inside, and he kept the ruby near the table. And then he went nearby that boy, and he started fanning with his wings for that boy. And the boy started feeling cool with this, and he started feeling better, and he fell asleep. Then the swallow flew back to the happy prince and told him what he had done. It is curious," he remarked, "but I feel quite warm now, although it is so cold." Okay, so the bird, he did his job, and he went back to the happy prince, and he told him that the things which he have done was very strange thing, that which he have never done before, and he is feeling quite warm after doing that. "This is because you have done a good action," said prince. So the prince replied him that just because he did a good thing, that is why he is feeling very warm, though it is very cold. And the little swallow began to think, and then fell asleep. Thinking always made him sleepy. So as usual, the bird was thinking about the day which he has spent, and this made him sleepy. When day broke, he flew down to the river, had a bath. "Tonight I go to Egypt," said the swallow. And he was high in spirit at the protest. And on the next day, he woke up and he went for bath. He cleaned himself. Okay, and he cleaned himself, and he said to the prince that he is going to flew to the Egypt now. And he was, you know, full of spirit. He visited all the monuments and sat a long time on the top of the church steeple. Okay, so therefore he visited every monuments in the city, in the happy city, and also sat and had a long sat on a top of the church steeple. When the moon rose, he flew back to happy prince. Okay, so when the in the evening, in the night, okay, this bird, it flew to the happy prince statue again. "Have you any commissions for Egypt?" he cried. "I am just starting." "Swallow, swallow, little swallow," said the prince, will you stay with me one night longer?" So as the swallow reached to the statue of this happy prince, he again, means the happy prince statue, again requested the swallow to stay for one night again with him. "I am waited for Egypt. I am waited for in Egypt," answered the swallow. "Swallow, swallow, little swallow," said the prince, "far away across the city, I see a young man in a garret. He is leaning over a desk covered with papers. His hair is brown and crisp and dreamy eyes." Okay, so again, this swallow was already ready to, you know, to go to flew to the Egypt, but he was being stopped by the statue of the happy prince. So this happy prince, he requested to the bird that he wanted him again to go to a man. Okay, there was a man in a garret who was lying on the table. Okay, and he was covered with papers. Clear, and in the glass by the side there is a bunch of withered violets. His hair is brown and crisp. So he is giving the description of that man, that the man who is lying on the table, he is having a brown hair and crisp hair, and his lips are red as a pomegranate, and he has large and a dreamy eyes. He is trying to finish a play for a director of a theater, but he is too cold to write anymore. Okay, so this this man who was lying on the table, he is a story writer, so he is not able to write a he is not able to complete a play which he has started. Okay, for a director of the theater, there is no fire in the grate and hunger has made him faint. Okay, so he was feeling very cold, and due to cold his hand got what stiff, and he was not able to write. And even his garret where the fire burns, okay, the chimneys, they did not had fire, and that is why the room had become very cold. I will wait with you one night longer, said the swallow, who really had a good heart. He asked if he should take another ruby to the young playwright. So next, you know, this bird swallow was very kind, and he agreed to stay with him one night longer, because he knew that this happy prince heart has a very good heart. Okay, and that is why he was ready to help him. And he also asked him to take off the another ruby so that he can help that poor man. Alas, I have no ruby now, said the prince. My eyes are all that I have left. They are made of rare sapphire, which were brought out of India 1,000 years ago. He ordered the swallow to pluck out of them and take it to the playwright. He will sell it to the jeweler and buy firewood and finish his play, he said. Clear? So we know that earlier, in order to help that woman, he already had taken out the rubies. Now there was no ruby left. So now he wanted, the rare sapphire which was placed in his eyes. He wanted that sapphire to take off, and he wanted that bird to sell that, means to give it to the playwright, so that the playwright can go and sell that, you know, in the jewelry shop, and he can buy a firewood with the sum of money he gets. Dear prince, said the swallow, I cannot do that, and he began to weep. And the this bird swallow, he started crying. He started saying that he cannot do that thing. He cannot take out his eyes. Swallow, swallow, little swallow, said the prince, do as I command you. So he commanded the bird and told him to do as he is told to do.